Hello, in this video I will show one example of using the VisualARQ Grasshopper styles with a beam object. I have basically created here a definition that generates this truss, so I can control the height of the truss, the vertical beam's distance, okay, or the profiles of each beam. At the end of this definition, I get different geometric components that collect the different parts of this truss system. So I have one geometric component for the vertical beams, another for the diagonals, another one for the top and bottom beams, and finally others for these plates. It's important that I name these components accordingly in order to later on identify them when I generate a beam style from this definition. So we'll save now the definition, we'll close Grasshopper, and we'll open the beam styles dialog by doing right click here. Here I will just generate a new style, so we'll select the Grasshopper style option. I'm going to select this Grasshopper definition, and here I just need to follow the steps of this wizard. So I need to define style name, select the definition units, and select one path curve of the definition that will perform as the beam path. The curve reference in the definition will be used for that purpose. When I click next, I see here the different components of the beam. Now, we can see here the list of all parameters that I had in the definition, and each one can be editable by a style, by object, or by definition, which means that will be hidden from VisualArq dialogs. For example, the vertical beam distance is something that I want to edit by object. Or the height of the truss will be also something that I want to edit individually by each instance. When I click finish, I have here the new beam with the rest of beam styles. So I can now create a beam, select this style and draw it in the model and have different ones, and later on select each one and change one of its parameters that I left editable by object. Now I can open a new definition here that generates a roof that covers one area. I can just set one curve. This generates this kind of array of trusses. I can change the span in one direction or in the other side, and the number of trusses that covers this area. So at the end of this definition, I use a beam component that gets this list of lines as their path curves. I need to set here one beam style, so I will do right click, set one beam style, and select that new style we have just created. And now, if I want to change one of the parameters of this style, I need this VisualArq set property component, and here assign a property
whose name
matches with the one existing property of the style, which is vertical beam distance. I can now assign a different value, and this will apply on all beams. Finally, I can bake these trusses and get them in Rhino.